Hi, Evan from the Nerdy Gardener here. My cabbage and broccoli plants have a problem. The leaves are being eaten by the larvae of the cabbage white butterfly, which leaves distinctive holes and chewed patches all over my plants. Cabbage white butterfly caterpillars feed mostly on plants in the Brassicaceae family. They're most commonly found on cabbage and broccoli, but can also be found feeding on cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, kale, mustard, kohlrabi, turnip, swede, bok choy and other Asian brassicas, radishes, alyssum, rocket, and various types of cress. They can also sometimes be found feeding on garden nasturtium leaves, as well as a few other plants from families in the same order as Brassicaceae. The life cycle of the cabbage white butterfly begins with the female adult laying clusters of little yellow eggs. The eggs are usually laid from spring to early summer. The eggs hatch into hairy little yellow caterpillars. The caterpillars molt through four more stages, turning green and becoming larger and more hungry as they grow. They then put down a silk pad to be paid on. I found this pupae on one of my Okinawa spinach plants. The adults emerge from the pupae, mate, and the females seek out a new host plant to lay their eggs on. The best way to prevent cabbage white butterflies from decimating your garden is to exclude the adult butterflies by building a mesh hoop house over any of your vegetable beds that you want to grow brassicas in. You can also crawl through your patch and remove them by hand by squishing them, or better yet, feeding them to your chickens or fish if you have an aquaculture system. But unfortunately, I don't have fish nor fowl, and my garden is a little too overgrown to manually remove them. So I'm going to try spraying them with an organically certified spray made from Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria. BT caterpillar killing spray comes in both a concentrated liquid as well as powdered forms, and is available in some form from most garden centers. It is commonly sold under the trade name Dipel. When the bacteria are sprayed onto the leaves and ingested, they produce a protein that acts as a stomach poison, causing the larvae to stop feeding straight away and eventually killing them within 3 to 4 days. The BT strain found in caterpillar killing products is the Kostaki strain, which is effective against most species of leaf-eating moth and butterfly larvae. This strain of BT is specific to caterpillars and will not harm worms in the soil or beneficial insects such as bees or ladybirds, and is safe to use around pets, animals, and people. BT spray has no withholding period. You can eat your produce straight away, but it's still a good idea to wash off any residue first. I'll be making up about a liter of spray as I don't have too many plants that need treating. You can use a hand sprayer, but I'll just be using a cheap 1 liter spray bottle. The BT spray I'm using is in a powdered form, and following the directions on the packet, I'll be using a mixing rate of 1 gram per liter of water. As I want to make 1 liter of spray, I'm going to use a spoon to measure out 1 gram of the powder. I'm then going to add half the water, 500 mils in this case, to the spray bottle. Now I'm going to add the powder carefully to the water and swirl the bottle to mix it. By adding only half the water initially, the powder will mix better and I'll avoid splashes. Now that the powder is mixed in, I'll add another 500 mil to make 1 liter of the spray and gently mix again. I'm going to begin by spraying my cabbage plants, making sure to get plenty of spray down onto the leaves of the forming head. I'm wearing gloves while spraying, as BT spray can be a skin irritant, although I'm not usually affected, so this is just an added precaution. BT should be applied as soon as young caterpillars or their damage is apparent, as it will not affect older caterpillars. Moving on to my collard greens, I'll treat them the same way, trying to wet both the top and undersides of each leaf. It's important to try to spray BT on both the upper and lower surface of the leaves for good coverage. BT is degraded by UV exposure from sunlight, so any BT sprayed on the underside of the leaf will remain active for longer than the spray on the top side. Because of this, it's also best to spray BT during late afternoon or dusk to maximize the length of time it's effective for. Again, exactly the same technique as before for spraying my purple sprouting broccoli plants. Because of its limited active life, It's important to respray BT every 5 to 7 days while cabbage white butterflies are active, especially on vital areas such as cabbage heads or broccoli florets, to control any newly hatching caterpillars. BT spray will be washed off the leaves by rainfall, so you may also need to reapply it after heavy rains. These young red Russian kale plants aren't showing much damage yet, but I'll give these a preventative spray anyway since I have mix left. And that's it. It's easy to prevent cabbage white caterpillars from eating your garden with selective organic Bacillus thuringiensis spray.